And for me, it's a little personal too. You know, I grew up in a rural parish. I remember when I went to Congress in 2010, one of the biggest complaints I got from residents in the rural parishes that I represented them, and especially the one I lived in, was that they couldn't get any internet. And so it's my pleasure to introduce to y'all first the fellow who's going to tell us how he's going to get that internet all over Louisiana, and that's Vineet Eingard. I practice that. And he is the executive director of the Office of Broadband Development and Connectivity. We also have Dr. Abraham, our Surgeon General. We have Senator Beth Mizell and Dow Desertel. I just want to point amongst all the other legislators that are here, but both Beth and Darryl, I think it was Darryl's bill that he drafted, and Beth handled it on the Senate side, that created the Office of Broadband Development and Connectivity. And you know, I know, you know, we always are talking about all the bad things that Louisiana has on the list that we're on. But this is a great shiny spot. This is a time under which Louisiana was ahead of its game, under which we had our political leaders seeing how important it was to be able to connect everyone in Louisiana and how to make sure that that technology reached the rural folks. Way before the federal government started giving us an opportunity to grab some federal dollars to do what Vineet is going to walk us through. And so I also want to thank, I know Senator Cassidy has, Brian's here, Senator Cassidy's has a representative, Senator Troy Carter's representatives here as well. I want to thank them for their help in this endeavor as well. And so now I'd like to bring up Vineet, and what I like about him is he's local, right? He grew up right here in Baton Rouge, and he is responsible for implementing this program. And I want to just say this, and he'll say it, and we'll continue to repeat it to make sure that the media understands this, but this is where Louisiana is first in the nation, okay? It is because of the leadership, because of the ability of the legislature and to see an opportunity, and then for them to put in place the right type of leadership, and under Vineet's leadership, I am convinced that we are going to beat all the other states in being able to get this money implemented in the most effective, efficient, and best way possible, so that all of these young people that are here can enjoy some nice broadband. And my quarterback over here, Bunky, right? He better watch his highlights in real time, right? So Vineet.
Thank you, folks. Thank you, folks, and really good morning. What a great way to start the week. What a great way to announce that the Gumbo 2.0 program has officially launched. We're the first fully approved state in the country. And what I mean by fully approved, it's we've received all the federal approvals starting from last December up until June, up until today, to actually launch the program. And I'll tell you, that's a really round of applause for everybody. And I'll tell y'all, folks, what drives us as an office every day, what drives the governor, what drives the legislature, what drives all of you as stakeholders, our team is only three people, but we're small and mighty, is the fact that we're inspired every day when we get up in the morning to solve the challenges that people have in rural Louisiana. The same very challenges that people that are behind me here, the people that are in front, and the people that are all throughout Louisiana have when it comes to better improving their lives both professionally and personally. And what's really important is a couple of weeks ago, I was in Denver at a big event, bringing a bunch of different broadband directors, and all of them said, Vineet, what's the secret to your success in Louisiana? And as the governor alluded to, this is an issue where there's absolute alignment between the governor, the legislature, all of you as stakeholders to singularly solve this problem. And we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it as quickly as possible. We'll be the first to do it. And so we're really thrilled that the program has officially launched and that within the next 6 to 8 weeks, we'll know what the results are for those projects, for those project areas that are impacting every single parish in the state of Louisiana. What's also equally important and some little inside baseball, and I think this is always important because sometimes folks forget the intricacies of the sausage making of what it takes to get to a point like today. In the first 100 days of the governor's administration, he said, Vineet, look, let's talk about broadband. Let's talk about the size of the problem. Let's talk about the depth of the problem. Let's truly understand where it is we're going to take these taxpayer federal funds to quickly address the needs that are impacting close to 400,000 residents, small businesses, and community anchor institutions that you see behind me here. So we started getting to work. In the last couple of months, we've had half a dozen meetings with the governor. Every time the governor goes and travels somewhere, he'll often text me, call me, and say, Vineet, these people need internet. Are they in the map? Are they on the map? Are they included? And oftentimes, I will have to scramble and get them the answers quickly. But fortunately, we've done a really good job in partnership with the legislature, in partnership with all of you, because frankly, all of you are telling us where the gaps are in your communities. We've taken all of those locations. We've created a first-rate map of where each individual household, business, and community anchor institution that truly lacks internet will receive internet. And so we've created a map, which is available on our website, connect.la.gov, for anyone to see. And we have nearly 140,000 specific addresses, households, and locations. And over the next 6 to 8 weeks, we're going to work with the internet service providers as it relates to the bidding platform, as it relates to executing on this program, as it relates to bidding on all this work. And I'll tell you, I think you can be in Louisiana very much pro-people and pro-private sector, and that's what we've done. And just to show you an example, to share you an example, in the first round of our Gumbo Grant Program 1.0, we had 18 different internet service providers apply for our funds. This time, we have nearly double that. We have 33 different ISPs who have looked at Louisiana, looked at the policies, looked at how we're going to execute, and have realized that they want to not only place their capital, but they want the best for all of Louisiana. And for that, Governor, thank you for your leadership. Thank you to all those people, to all the folks behind me and in front of you that drive us every day to ensure that we wake up in the morning thinking about how are we going to solve the problem, and then sleeping at night thinking, did we solve the problem? The last thing, and this is really Lanyap, and this is really a potential awesome opportunity, is the fact that in Act 632 that the governor signed into law, that Rep. Desitel, that Senator Beth Mizell, and all the legislators pushed, is the fact that in the event that we do have extra funds, and there is a possibility that we would have extra funds, that we would create a grant program to focus on three especially key areas that the governor has a particular interest in. How do we improve, economically speaking, the state of Louisiana? How do we use these broadband dollars to improve our workforce development efforts? And then how do we improve the healthcare efforts of our state of Louisiana? And so with that, it's my honor and privilege to introduce Congressman, Doctor, the first Surgeon General for the history of Louisiana, among other things, a broadband expert, Doc Abraham.
Well, thank you, Vineet. From day one of his administration, Governor Landry instructed our team at LDH to improve access to all Louisianians, but especially those in places like I work, the Delta, along that Mississippi River, down in the southern part of the state, along the Gulf. Those individuals that want good health, need good health, but may not can access that health because there is no connectivity, there is no telehealth. The public health units that they go to may not have that high-speed internet that they need to get the type of results that we need to improve their lives. So with the governor's and Vineet's work, this is literally a gift that has been laid in our laps that we are going to take and do really, really good things with. I've said it many times, I'll say it again, I've never met anybody that wanted to be poor. I've never met anybody that wanted to be unhealthy. With these extra funds that we are going to have access to now, we can make a dent in those types of populations that want to help their lives, want to help their families, and economically will help this state. So I can't express my gratitude to the mandate and the instructions that the governor has given us and given us the ability and the authority to go out and conquer these problems. And now we've got people like Vineet in the broadband development and connectivity office that are working on the national level and allowing these funds to come back down to the state and, more importantly, the very local level that all of us live in on a day-to-day basis. So, Governor, I'm going to turn it back over to you. Again, thank you for your leadership, and Denise, thank you for the funding.
Just a couple of things to lay out before we close and take some questions. I think it's important to recognize, again, that this project and the task that Vineeth and his team have, it will hit on all of the key areas and help us improve the three key areas that we made pledges to the people of Louisiana that we were going to improve in. We told them that we were going to work on public safety and on crime and increasing broadband and high-speed internet and access to our law enforcement offices in rural Louisiana helps to fulfill that as well. We said we would work on education and making sure that kids in rural areas of Louisiana have the same access as do those in the big cities, puts them on an even playing field from an educational standpoint as well. And then from an economic standpoint, this project is slated to help, I think it was over 26,000 small businesses. This is a project that impacts Main Street, not Wall Street. It impacts Main Street. And so it helps us fulfill that goal. And it also is one, and let me just say this too, because I think it's important that while we talk about how great the program is and how we're moving and the speed of light that we want to move it to, I want folks from Louisiana to understand that it comes with some sacrifice. We've got to lay the fiber. These companies have to go out there and put it in place. So we would ask for your patience, but Vineeth is, he's going to move fast, and we're going to keep the public updated. But again, you know, you may see something, you know, some discomfort in that as they lay the ground. Like they might break a water line, which we want to work on. They might tear up a phone line, which again, we want to work on. But all of the things that you're going to see are the sacrifices that we are going to entail to make the progress needed to move Louisiana into a new industrial South. And that's what's on the table here. This is our opportunity to lay a foundation. This is the best foundational opportunity that Louisiana has to move us towards creating great jobs, to improving our education, to helping our law enforcement officers be safer, more wiser, quicker in the work that they do. And so, Vineeth, I know you're going to create the efficiencies in it, because I tell the legislature, all of our cabinet folks out there working on efficiencies so we can close the budget gap. But your efficiency is even more important because, again, the efficiencies that you create cost savings that we can then plow in to the three areas that we talked about, which is workforce development, rural health care, which is so vitally important. And then let me say this too. Not only is it going to affect 26,000 small businesses, but it's also going to affect over 4,000 civic institutions, schools, city halls, police departments, parish council rooms, all of those government functions in rural Louisiana that absolutely does not have the ability to reach the internet as quickly as maybe those in the big cities as well. So finally, with that, I just want to say one thing, buddy. Where's that quarterback? Come see over here. But here's your project. All right. We need him to be able to play in Cecilia and not have to do like we all did way back in the day, have to wait till the 10 o'clock news and then the sports is at the end to see it. He'll be able to watch it in real time as the bus travels from Cecilia to Monkey, right? Is that fair?
That's fair.
All right. Okay. If he doesn't do it, you let me know. Okay, so with that, we'll take some questions. Yes, ma'am. Well, look, I think one of the things we could do is take advantage of the fact that we have this great infrastructure improvement and start to work on a way under which we can start to map out where those utilities are. okay? Where are the water lines? Where are the sewer lines? I can tell you that you can go, like, they don't like to admit it. I know I see a couple of our small town folks that are municipalities. It's hard for them to remember where some water or sewer lines or vital infrastructure is in place. I think the answer to that is what Representative Desitel has, is that we should be able to work with local governments and come out with a comprehensive mapping system. This gives us an opportunity to figure out a way where we know what exactly is in the ground. And of course, we understand those challenges. And I think that the best way to answer that question is to make sure that as we move forward, we know where everything is. We know when you dig, this is where, even when you call Louisiana One Call, I know it. Right in the city of Lafayette, we did some construction at the house, and they thought the sewer line was one place, and it ended up being another. So I think this gives us an opportunity to actually reset or reboot where our vital infrastructure is in the state. Any other question? Yep. Yeah, we'd love to be able to find that out. I mean, I'd love to be able to answer that question. We'll get that if we try to stick. I mean, all these young kids came over here to see us, make sure that we could get them the technology. But y'all are getting a great lesson on what the media does. They love to try to take it off of the greatness that we're doing here to talk about something else. Okay, any other questions? Yes, ma'am. I'll let Vineet answer that.
Look, that's a great question. And the reality is, the governor wants to drive fiber as far and deep into the state as possible. It's like the equivalent of basically making I-49, I-20, a 20-lane concretized highway, including all the state roads, right? That's the goal. And so now the reality is, as the bids come in, that there might be locations or project areas where the cost of building fiber is way too expensive. In that case, through the legislation that was passed in Act 632 and others, that we are technology neutral as a state. So we'll accommodate other kinds of technologies, whether it's low Earth orbit satellites, or whether it's fixed wireless, to take care of those folks that we think is not gonna attract the kinds of bids that we want for those locations, especially on the fiber side. Yes, they are.
Any other questions? Okay, well, again, I really want to thank everyone who came here today, the legislators that are here to come and see the great fruits of their labor. We look forward to updating Louisiana on the progress that we're making, and I can't wait for my man to watch his game from Cecilia to Bunky. Thank you so very much.